But let's now look at what business benefits that our OSS and BSS generate. What you saw on the previous slide was quite technical. Clearly, there are many roles and functions performed by telco staff, which is why there are thousands of people employed in operational roles. But you might be taking a more executive perspective and wondering how OSS and BSS really make a difference for a telco. What are the benefits they generate? Many people just see them as a cost center, a necessary evil that costs millions of dollars to install and then maintain each year. The problem with cost centers is that financial teams are always looking for ways to reduce the size of those costs. What most people don't realize is that OSS and BSS offer far more business value than that. First things first, they generate revenue. They connect customers with the product, whereby the product is the network. They're responsible for onboarding customers onto the network and then billing them for the utilization of network resources. They operationalize the network. Without these functions, there would be a massive investment in network infrastructure, but no customers paying to provide a return on that investment. Next, they act as an insurance policy for the network. They identify outages or degradations in the network. They coordinate efficient remedial activities. They ensure consistent availability of network capacity. They ensure stable quality of customer services end to end. But ultimately, all of these factors are insurance against the telco's most dreaded word, churn. That's the word they use to describe a customer leaving, moving to take up a service with a competitor. Our systems also generate operational efficiency within the organization. OSS and BSS are built around defined processes. Being IT systems allow automations of some or all of these steps within these processes. They drive consistency and repeatability, which allows for ongoing optimization. Every day sees updates and improvements, largely built on the back of OSS tools, because they drive systematic behaviors across an operator's organization and tech stack. And speaking of optimization, in any given day, there are hundreds, perhaps thousands of people interacting with and getting guidance from our OSS and BSS. These are the types of people we discussed earlier. So, for example, a field worker might be responsible for connecting new customers by installing new cables from homes to the network infrastructure running down their streets. If just one customer is unable to let the worker onto the premise, then the worker's schedule is impacted, with ripple out effects. It's the OSS and BSS that allocate the schedule now, and after the missed customer appointment, the OSS and BSS needs to recommend a next best action for the worker. That is, what's the next best job to attend? In addition to the cost control and reduction benefits of doing things more efficiently, operational efficiency can also drive some revenue benefits. There's faster turn on of customer services, from weeks down to days, and therefore a faster turn on of revenue. There's a faster turn on of new product offerings, from months down to days or weeks, which can lead to faster turn on of revenue, also beating out customer acquisition from other competitors. Our OSS and BSS are continually reviewing data and optimizing on the fly. Not just for field workers, as we described in the example, but for many roles and transactions that we have also discussed. Speaking of data, OSS and BSS generate and process massive amounts of data every day. Data from which important insight generation can be derived. They collect data across many different roles and different domains, so there's operational data, like network health and asset management, customer data like addresses, services, spend, market segment, and more. There's usage and billing data. There's location data of equipment and assets. And these can all be used not just to generate insights within a single domain, but have huge potential if we analyze data sets that go across domain. For example, if we compare network asset locations with existing customer locations, we might find areas where there is available network capacity, but few connected customers. This type of information can be valuable for the sales and marketing teams, for lead generation. And all of these factors, if working well, can lead to two other really important attributes for a telco. Because all of the processes, resources, and customers that are monitored and managed by OSS and BSS, these tools have the potential to have a significant impact on competitive advantage. Either in the positive, if the OSS and BSS are working well, or in the negative, if they're not. And ultimately, all of these factors above have an impact on customer satisfaction and brand value. If a telco's OSS and BSS are ineffective, this can result in customer grievances, which impacts brand value. If a carrier becomes known for lengthy service activation times, network outages, incorrect bills, poor customer service, and more, then its brand value is severely impacted.